Welcome back to the workshop. Up next on our I Never Know What to Get Dad for Christmas, showing off cool tools, we're going to be taking a look. You've seen these all over Facebook. They've been advertising on Facebook really hard. They sent this over for my review, so I want to thank Vevor for sending this over. V-E-V-O-R is how you spell their name. They've got a gajillion types of tools on their website. They sell through Amazon, their own website. We've got one of their pneumatic, which means air-powered, jacks for your vehicle. This thing is a compact size. It's got a nice handle, comes in a blue paint. You can choose other colors. This has an 11,000 pound lifting capacity, they claim, which is 5.5 tons for us in the United States. It'd be 2,000 pounds per ton, 10,000 pounds would be a 5-ton jack. This is 11,000 pounds, so this could lift anything you've probably got at home, unless it's a tractor trailer and stuff like that. But this is going to lift your F-350s, your F-250s, your dually trucks, anything like that can be lifted with this jack. Comes needing assembly, which isn't all that hard, and I'm not going to do it on camera. We'll demonstrate how it works after it's assembled. But all you'll need to do when it arrives is you'll have to take this hose, you'll have to run it through the bottom handle, and it's the bottom handle because it has these pins in it. And the pins will interlock into the base of the jack so that you can move the jack around and lift it up at different angles and wheel it around on its solid casters. It's got solid plastic casters to get it around the shop because this thing is not a lightweight. I usually carry it by this handle. I have been into the shop, and this thing is heavy. It's got to be 30 pounds of steel, if not more. This base is incredibly heavy. Comes with this nice, thick rubber pad for jacking, so you're not going to scratch your limited edition special fancy cars. Measure that across there, and that is 3.5 inches across the top. Yep, 3.5 inches, so, and it is replaceable. And it does rotate a little bit, and it is a nice flexible rubber with grips in the top so it doesn't scratch the heck out of your frame or your differentials or anything else, you know, your custom aluminum control arms, anything like that. This won't scratch it. It stands about 5¾ inches tall to the top of the rubber to the ground when deflated. It's got 3 airbags, which are made out of a very hard, but it's very stiff, but it's flexible, plastic type. And then it reaches heights up to 15.75 inches. 15¾ inches is the maximum height. When you assemble the handle, all you're going to have to do is run the hose from the base through your upper handle, which has all the business end on it for operation, out this little hole here. So you'll just reach in with some pliers and pull it out when you get it up that far. Just turn it and even kind of comes out itself. You'll run it in and run it into this compression fitting. This hose is very stiff. It has to be to handle, you know, 120 PSI. It's very stiff, so when you attach it to your compression fitting here, you'll want to warm this end with like a heat gun or something. Or if you live in a warmer climate that's unlike Wisconsin at 14 degrees this morning, you won't have to, but you'll want to warm it up and slide it in there. This is your operational end of the jack. This is your handle to move it around with. You've got your green line, and obviously this is your air input. You need an air compressor to run this. Having an air compressor of a substantial size is helpful. You can run it with a air tank or a small pancake compressor. You can, but I have a 50-gallon upright in the garage, which is much more. It'll run this much faster and provide more air without having to run all the time. To fill the jack, you will red handle, green handle, see the colors. The red handle needs to close the valve. So when you're thinking of these valves, straight in line with the valve means it's allowing airflow. Turned perpendicular, 90 degrees, cuts off all airflow. So to fill the jack, both handles will be down. You hook up your airline, make sure the red handle stays perpendicular, and then slowly lift the green handle to full and fill up your bladders. and fill up your jack and raise it up to the height. It also gives you the directions here, but it's quite easy to do from here. Now, you close this when you want to stop filling it. You don't have to lift it all the way every time. You don't have to lift it super fast. In fact, no one recommends you jack a car at max speed. Just regulate your lift speed by moving that valve. Then when you want to lower it, you will leave this valve closed once it's raised to its max height that you want it to be at, and you will slowly open the red release valve. Slowly open the red release valve until you're letting it out or letting the car down as far as you want to go. If you need to instantly release air, like an emergency situation, I guess, and you couldn't operate this one, this safety release valve is here. And this will also blow if you reach an overpressure stage. This little ringlet just allows you to pull it. So if you reach an overpressure stage through the line, this will pop and blow before you blow the bladder up. It includes the hardware needed to assemble the handle. It's just some galvanized steel to bolt the handles together once you get your airline run and attach it to the base. So I'm going to do all that, then we'll take it out in the garage and we'll lift up my truck. The jack is assembled. All you have to do is attach the handle by the bolt on the bottom and the four bolts and the clamps across the top center of the handle here. And those all hold together. They do include nylon lock nuts, so you won't have to worry about it. It's a 10 millimeter nut and bolt on here. It is a 13 millimeter nut down here. The handle will store completely upright. Then you can also move the handle to one of a couple other locations underneath so that you can move the jack and move it around as you need to. Any position, this one's a lot easier to use here. And you can lift it up, wheel it around, and once you have it on the wheels, it doesn't feel heavy at all with that nice little handle. When you want to store it out of the way, the handle sits up there and locks in. You can easily move that under a vehicle just by lifting it up, sliding it where you want to go, hook up your airline to your connectors here, and get to lifting. And then when you're done, you just lift it up, drag it out of the way, put it where you want in the shop, and store it. It's that simple. So let's get lifting the truck right now. Now we are underneath the frame, of course, the suspension and everything of my 2020 Tacoma TRD Pro, which sits a little bit higher than other Tacomas because of the factory lift, but it doesn't matter because we're going to be lifting it on the rear axle, so it's the same height. And it's got a healthy amount of ground clearance, as you can see, as the Tacomas do or any pickup truck does, and it's a hefty truck. I think the curb weight on this thing is 4,400 pounds or 4,800 pounds. It's not a lightweight truck, so we're not lifting a tiny little Honda Civic here or something like that. So I've got the jack underneath the vehicle. Now I'm not going to do a class on proper jacking. You take all the safety precautions you need to take to make sure that you are safe when you're under the vehicle. We can see the jack and the handle is laid down so it fits underneath the truck, and we've got our valves set up. I've got this set up to my compressor, running 90 PSI, that's what I always run in my tools anyways, so I just left that setting there. We've got our valve, you can see it's red, to let the bags all the way down. You can see they're compressed down there. And then we will close that valve to contain air in the valves. And then we've got our hose lined up. I had a little bit of extra hose so you can safely loop it around like so that you don't pinch it, or you can cut it off, but I figured leave it a little long in case it wears and I need to replace it. So slid it underneath. We're going to lift it right on the shackle there on the spring so we get the full lift effect. and then we will open this valve, and it starts to work pretty quick. You'll just barely open it and the bags will start to go up, and the more pressure you lift it, for the more weight you're lifting. So let's go back. We'll start to open it and we'll see if we can get it all on camera. See if we can get everything on camera in one. It's kind of hard to see the frame. There we go. Let's see if we can get it all on there. It moves pretty quick once it starts to go. Now lift slowly. There you go. And up goes the truck, and then we close our valve. And there we go. She's up. It can be worked on. It's stable because it's got the huge base and the nice big rubber foot underneath the spring, so you're not damaging anything. It's not blowing any air out the back. It's not having any fits. Make sure you shut this valve off. You don't want to keep pushing air into it. It will release itself once the bags are full. I did inflate it to the full pressure all the way up, and it does exhaust its own air once it's reached the maximum lift level. But still, you want to make sure that you're not overstressing these. And we can see that it's lifted up nicely. We can easily pull the tire off. We can do whatever work we need to do. And we didn't have any issues reaching it even on a pickup truck. So now to release it, we make sure that this valve stays closed. And then we will open this valve. And you can open this at any speed you want. Obviously go kind of slow so that the vehicle lowers itself down. We'll see if we can get that all on camera again. So we'll get the valve in the frame and the tire. And then we'll just, with one hand, and slowly let the truck bring itself down. And then once the tire is touching the ground, we'll go ahead and open the valve all the way, and the air will continue to come out. And eventually, once it loses all its pressure, the bag detaches from the spring there and slowly lowers itself down. It's not a fast process. It's wide open right there. And there we go. Kind of lets itself loose and slowly deflates. And it's that easy. It works that easy. You can jack your vehicle up. We'll close that valve, leave the air in there. You can lift your vehicle. It does take quite a bit of air out of the compressor, so those little pancake compressors will have a hard time keeping up if you're using this a lot, but we can just go ahead and up it goes to full stretch. And we're all ready to work on the vehicle. Now, obviously, you want to use safety when you have this under it. So if you're going to go under the vehicle, put your jack stands under it. Use common sense. I'm not teaching a class on common sense or how to do it. But it's very, very easy to use this jack. And I love how fast it works and how the air comes out and it releases it. Since my compressor is always running, it's not hard to use at all. And then simply let the bag drop until you're all done. And that is it. So it works quite well. It's easy to use. There's no problems. As you can see, it is lifting a pickup truck, a real TRD Pro, not a TRD Bro, not a fake one. It's easy to get under the truck. And when the bags drop far enough, all you gotta do is grab it and drag it out. Don't get caught on your mat there. But yeah, you can just drag it out. Lift it, or you can lift by the frame, by the axles. Everything works simple, and the handle stores upright when you're all done. So we thank Vivor for sending this over. It's going to be a handy tool in the garage. Rotate your own tires. You can set up your jack stands, lift a whole vehicle in just a couple minutes instead of pumping on a jack forever to get stuff off the ground. And it seems nice and quiet and safe. I will link in the description where you can grab yours, and we'll see all of you at the next review.